Oh God. Whatever, I'm holding it. Sorry, hopefully this doesn't make you seasick. But good morning and welcome to today's video. So during this self-isolation, I know that for me personally, and I'm sure a lot of you, it has been very difficult to get self-motivated to do workouts. Even though I'm very thankful for my basement and the equipment that I have in here, I also just don't really find it very motivating, like being down here by myself in the cold, dark dungeon of a basement, you know, it's just like not super fun. So one of the things I've been doing is like making sure that I start my morning off with my regular routine, have my breakfast, taking the dogs for a walk, do my to-do list, and then like putting on really cute clothes. Because maybe this is just me, but I feel like when you put on cute workout clothes, you definitely are more motivated to work out. Maybe it's just me, but I love it. This is the Lululemon Swiftly Tech 2.0 tank and the Invigorate High Rise 25-inch pants. Look at these, look how cute they are. Really feeling my outfit today. And so I wanted to take you through a body weight workout, but also kind of talk about how you can sub things out for yourself. Obviously running, that's something anybody can do outside if the weather is nice. It's still cold here. I don't understand. It's sunny today, but it's like 40. So as much as I would like to work out outside in the sun, I'm down here today. But even if you have something like a gallon of water or something like an odd object, you can totally use that for weight, a jump rope, like those are very basic things. So I'm gonna just show you a couple of options as far as modifications, go through a bodyweight workout and just hopefully motivate some of you guys who have been struggling to work out to get up and go outside or maybe in your living room, whatever, and do some bodyweight workouts. Before I work out, I always warm up running. That's just my go-to. I feel like it gets me the warmest, the fastest. And I don't know, ever since I moved from Florida to Iowa, I am cold all the time. I literally put my heat on and blast that hot air down here in the basement so that I can work out in like a hot environment. So I always like to run to warm up. Yes, we like to run around here. And then whatever you're going to do for the day, I would highly recommend having a doggie, because you make everything so much funner. Whatever you're deciding to do for the day, I would always write it down, make a plan. Are you gonna do an EMOM, an every minute on the minute style workout? Are we gonna do an AMRAP, as many rounds of reps as possible? Are we doing a HIIT style where we're gonna run or do something Tabata style? There's so many different options that you can do, and I know it can be overwhelming to basically make up your own workout. So just thinking off of the top of my head, some body weight movements that you can literally do anywhere. Burpees, the worst, honestly. Air squats, jumping lunges, reverse step lunges. I mean, you can literally just do jumping jacks. Anything with your body that gets your heart rate up. There are so many different things that you can do. Really anything ab related, if you wanted to add like a core piece after your workout, pretty much all abs are body weight unless you wanted to add weighted stuff for your abs. So for this first EMOM that I'm gonna start out with, I'm going to do an every minute on the minute for 14 minutes, 5 air squats, 5 push-ups, and 3 broad jumps. If you don't have enough room, either in your living room or wherever you're doing this body weight workout, you can do like jumping air squats or you can do burpees. So either way is fine, I'll show you both. Your EMOMs or AMRAPs or do kind of a more strength-based, you can totally separate that. For example, focusing on lower body doing a workout, maybe a 10-minute AMRAP of like air squats, lunges, forward and reverse lunges would be one rep, and then something like jump squats, or if you have any type of weight that you can hold it in the front rack position or hold them at your sides if you have dumbbells. If you do have a light set of dumbbells, a great way to get a super good workout in is death by thrusters, or you can even do death by burpees, which basically just means if you have weights, you can do the thrusters. Just going into a squat and a push press. just like this. Start on minute one and do one thruster for that minute. Rest until minute two, do two thrusters. On minute three, you do three, four, five, six, so on and so forth, until you can no longer complete the amount of reps within that minute time frame. Burpees are super hard to do that one with. Death by burpees is just a really fun way to get your heart rate up and practice your burpees, but if you do have some equipment, you can also do that same concept with thrusters or anything with weights. So for this next one, I'm going to switch it up from an EMOM and go to an AMRAP, and in this one, I'm going to do some core and also some legs and glutes. So in this workout, I'm going to do a 10-minute AMRAP of 10 hollow rocks, and I'll show you the modification for that, 10 pistol squats, and then 10 glute bridges. So if you do have weights and you wanna use the weights on your hips for the glute bridges, you totally can, but the way that this workout will look. Cardio at the end. Whenever I'm doing a full body weight workout, I typically like to do three portions. So like I said, I'll pick one EMOM, one AMRAP, and then either some type of HIIT or something to kind of just get a finisher, like a cardio finisher. If you wanted to just do it with running, you totally can. And I like to keep this part around 10 minutes. So what you could do is 10 rounds of 30 seconds of running, like hard effort, and then 30 seconds rest or slow cool down paced walking. But you can also do the same type of thing with air squats, jumping squats, jumping lunges, anything to really get your heart rate up, you could do at the end of your EMOM and AMRAP. If you have a jump rope, it would be super awesome to do with a jump rope, but if not, you can always do line hops, which is basically just where you'd be jumping back and forth over a line. We're gonna finish off with some abs. So for this one, this is probably one of my favorite ab finishers that I throw into my week, like maybe once a week or just when I feel like I need a little bit extra. What you're going to do is try to go through all of these with as little break as possible. You're going to rest 1 minute and then repeat. Workout, definitely let me know. And if you have any other like, oh, that's a nice girl. Have any other like resources that you use or you think I could review or something for an at-home workout, definitely leave me a comment down below. But now I have to go and take little Miss to the vet and Bailey too, because if you've been following me on Instagram, probably know that Bailey was sick the week before last week and so was Eliza. And so I just wanna kind of get them checked up. I'm sure they're fine because they're fine now, but can I be too safe? And I have like 5 minutes and I am not going to change, because shout out to Lululemon for always being super fast drying and anti-stink. Fun fact for you, did you know that, I just learned this recently, Lululemon uses this silver scent technology in the Swiftly Tech 2.0 shirt and in the Invigorate high-rise tights, and it's called Ecstatic, and it helps inhibit the growth of the sweaty, stinky bacteria, especially in the like high sweat areas, so you don't get like the nasty sweat stains and you don't smell, oh, excuse you. Speaking of nasty, and you don't smell like stink, so I can go to the vet without being a complete gross disaster. I really do like this new Swiftly Tech 2.0, and this was the first time that I was trying out these Invigorate high-rise tights for a workout, because I know like I usually wear my Aligns for working out, which you're not technically supposed to do, so I think that these will definitely replace. They were super comfortable, nothing fell down, and they still feel really cooling. Like I don't feel like I'm drenched in sweat, which is awesome. So anyways, I'm gonna take them to the vet, and that is a wrap for today's video. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in my next.